Good afternoon, everyone. It's like 37 degrees out. I just got out of the sauna and I wrote out content for a couple videos that I'm gonna record. A few videos I'll record today. Two or three. This video is about, it's on goals and prayers. So, number one, why not to set goals, and number two, why you shouldn't beg or ask God for things. So, number one, you don't want to set goals, and this is something I learned recently from a book called The Toltec Way by Susan Gregg. And the reason you don't set goals is if you set a goal, the thought behind that goal is that it's something that you haven't achieved already. So it'll always remain kind of in the unattainable future, just beyond your grasp as a goal. It's like, it reminds me of dangling a snack from the end of a fishing pole in front of your dog and running around in circles. And it's something that will stay in front of him and he can chase around, but he'll never actually get the treat. He'll never catch it. So that's why you don't set goals. And why, similarly, for a similar reason, you don't ask God for things in your prayers. And what you do instead is, or actually here, I'll just explain why you don't ask God for things first, or beg him for things. And it's, again, the same thing. It's the thought behind the thought. So for every prayer, there's something called a sponsoring thought, which is the thought behind that thought. And I found this in... Conversation with God, the book, it says, it's all about the thought behind the thought. Therefore, if you beg and supplicate, you have a smaller chance of experiencing your choice, because the sponsoring thought behind every supplication is that you do not have now what you wish. That sponsoring thought becomes your reality. So this is why asking God for things or begging him for things or supplicating him for things doesn't work, is because it implies that you don't already have it, and that lack is something, it's that lack is the thought behind your prayer, and that's the thought that becomes reality. So what to do instead? What to do instead for goals? Instead of setting a goal, you create an expected outcome. So you expect that what you want to happen, you expect that the outcome occurs favorably. You say, I'm going to achieve, say this to yourself, I'm going to achieve X expected outcome so that I can take X next step. Always add the next step at the end. I'm going to be happy. So here's an example. I'm going to win the basketball game today so that I can go to bed happy tonight. Winning the basketball game is the expected outcome. And going to bed happy is the expected next step. So always add the next step after your expected outcome. and set expected outcomes with the next step instead of creating goals, because goals will always remain in the not too distant future. What to do with prayers instead of asking, begging, or supplicating in your prayers. I'll just give you a definition of what a prayer should be according to a conversation with God. A prayer is a prayer of thanksgiving. It is not a request, but a statement of gratitude for what is so. So, a prayer is gratitude and thanksgiving. It's not asking or requesting or supplicating or begging. And a couple things about prayers is, as indicated in the book, is that all prayers are creative to some degree. So every time you pray, it does change the future a little bit. Next is that all prayers are accepted. God doesn't discriminate between prayers from one person or prayers from another. And further, God doesn't have preference for what prayers, or God doesn't have preference for how you live your life. He doesn't care if you marry X person or another person. He doesn't care what you do with your life. He might recommend certain ways of living that are safer than others, but he doesn't really have an opinion on what you do with your life. Ultimately, what you want to do with your life is what God wants you to do with your life. And so this is how prayers work. The degree that the prayer is held fervently, to the degree that the prayer is held fervently as truth, to that degree will be made manifest in your experience. So, as deeply as you can convince yourself it to be true, is as real as it will become in your life. And finally, this is how you're supposed to, this is how prayers are meant to be. You're supposed to thank God in advance for that which you choose to experience in your reality. So, instead of a prayer of supplication, you say a prayer of gratitude. And this is a quote from the book. When you thank God in advance for that which you choose to experience in your reality, you, in effect, acknowledge that it is there. In effect. Thankfulness is thus the most powerful statement to God. An affirmation that even before you ask, God has answered. Therefore, never supplicate, instead appreciate. And you can make this affirmation that even before you ask, God has answered, because you know that God automatically accepts all prayers as long as you accept it as truth for yourself. So, instead of setting goals, set expected outcomes. And instead of praying in request for things, pray with gratitude and the expectation that your prayer will be answered. Instead of praying through request, say, God, thank you for the money that is coming to me swiftly. God, thank you for helping me win this basketball game today so that I can go to bed happy tonight. Those are the type of prayers you want to be making. Alright, guys. have one more video coming for you today, and thanks for watching, thanks for listening, thanks for subscribing and posting daily for the next 6 months, like I said. And sorry for taking a day off yesterday. I recorded a couple videos for you, but I decided not to post them. Enjoy.
Grizz. Modest Yahoo. I'm a give up like you. I'm a go back here. Fighting for our peace with the violence. People trading blood with the diamonds. I feel like we might never learn. Shots to the sky, shots to the sky. Shadows we use to fight darkness. But it's the light that we need to harness. Make the world glow with reflection. They bring guns and guns and bullets and some more. To the youth get shot, blood drop on the floor. To them can't understand what you're fighting for no more. I got to open up that door to a new wave. It's a new day. So leave your boxes and bullets and chains on the floor. It's a new wave. It's a new day. Rise up to the light. The sound is so pure. It's a new wave. It's a new. In these trying times, what you fighting for? It's a new way, it's a new day. Keep your head up high till we end this war.